in our study, we focus on three elements that communication practitioners should consider for developing an effective communication-based response to disinformation. First, the content of the message that they want to promote. Second, the medium that they want to use to deliver it. And third, the audience that they want to target. And let me start from message. The key factor to be considered here is that disinformation and hostile actors exploit and amplify people's existing fears. So regardless of whether they are legitimate or not, these concerns are real, they are there. And in this context, we argue that communicators should acknowledge widely held concerns. Ignoring them, in our view, and this is an argument we make in the paper, would make it virtually impossible to reach out to those who are most exposed to disinformation and the fear-mongering articles that stoke anxieties that Paul described. So what we recommend in our study is that the communicators craft messages that resonate with public concerns. However, what we also argue is that acknowledging widely held concerns does not mean amplifying or reproducing these fears. So to calm insecurities, it is important that communicators say more about the desired change than about the problem. And what communicators and other practitioners should do is crafting messages that reflect the aspirations and wishes that lie behind fears and insecurities. So another important element of the message content is that, as Paul described, concerns change over time and that they also vary from place to place. So for this reason, communication practitioners should keep a close eye on external events, and where needed, they should refocus and adapt their messages on new overriding concerns. And they, of course, should also promote messages that have social currency in the specific locality in which they operate. As far as the medium is concerned, in our study, we recommend that communicators working for public institutions and international organizations in particular do not take for granted that they are in the best position to deliver the message. These institutions and organizations in our study we have found are also the target of discrediting campaigns. And this makes it difficult for them to counter disinformation and take a leading role in communication-based responses to it. So what we recommend in our study is that communicators involve trusted messengers for promoting alternative narratives. So in our view, the best messengers are those who already enjoy a bond of trust with the people who are being targeted. And what we have in mind are community leaders, such as the clergy, doctors, and employers. But of course, cultural figures and celebrities as well can also help, particularly we think if they have a migratory background themselves, because in these cases they can promote the message, but also encourage other migrants and specific categories of migrants, such as refugees, to become actively involved in shaping and circulating a more balanced narrative about migration. The third and final suggestion that we make in our study, which concerns the audience, is that communication practitioners focus on middle groups and on the conflicted middle in particular. Disinformation actors, what we have found in our study is that disinformation actors aim to polarize the debate, and we think that those in the middle are at great risk of being manipulated by these polarizing efforts. However, those in the conflicted middle are also the ones that are more pragmatically open to alternative narratives that are coherent with their values and priorities. So in answering to this question, we must remember that lies and half-truths contribute to shape people's perception about migration. And to a great extent also, they set the tone of the political agenda. So in order to avoid the polarization of the debate to which disinformation contributes, and to prevent hostile frames from having an effect, we think that alternative narratives are very helpful. And what we think is also that the important element is to strengthen resilience, and so not so much to respond to disinformation and single cases of information, but rather to undermine the appeal of disinformation narratives. And we use a metaphor in our study to describe these. We think that it is important to create a vaccine against disinformation rather than a cure that can work in all circumstances.